King Ken of County Hall regained his throne at 2:30 this afternoon, amid cheers and applause from his supporters. Earlier, he claimed the by-election that brought him back, called a stunt and a hollow victory by the Tories, had in fact seriously undermined the government's plan to axe the GLC.
The vital thing is the government cannot now claim to have a mandate from Londoners for abolition of the GLC. If they thought they could have got that, they would have stood. And that's their last remaining argument to support abolition.
Meanwhile, the Conservative group had been going about their own post-election business, voting by 30-9 to expel rebel member George Tremlett, who'd urged voters to back Labour candidates. Tremlett emerged from the meeting describing it as a public hanging.
What are you going to do now? Where do you go from here?
I think the first thing I'll do will be have a stiff scotch, I think, after an experience like that.
And what about politically?
Politically, I just don't know. I mean, I've never been one of those people who sort of calculates every move in advance. I came into politics because I believe in certain principles. That faith has never left me. I mean, I've stuck by those principles.
Do you think any of the 9 people who voted for you at the meeting will be following you out?
I wouldn't think so.
My duty is to stand fast where I am, because in that capacity I do have the opportunity to make myself a considerable bloody nuisance, and that's exactly what I intend to do.
George Tremlett says that he feels as though he's just been hung. Do you think that's a fair description of what happened to him?
Yes, I'm sure he feels that. I mean, George and I haven't had a time to have a private discussion. Yes, I'm sure he feels that. But he mustn't worry. The whole history of this country, political and religious, is bestrewn with martyrs, and he is a live martyr, and that must be nice.
Behind the public drama, a curious scene unfolded in Tremlett's office as political enemies met for once in complete accord.
They arrived to find you've been purged, as though this is 1930s Russia.
Were you labouring?
No, I must sit back in.
I haven't got a seat.
No idea.
Back in the chamber, Tremlett finally found a new seat, and that private alliance was made public.
It is my view that the leader of this council, Mr. Livingstone, John McDonald, Mr. Kendall, Lewis Cowley, were courageous in making the stand upon point of principle. They laid their seats on the line.
But this unprecedented accord is in spirit only. Livingstone won't be offering Tremlett a seat on his side of the chamber, and Tremlett, for his part, says he's still a true blue Tory. Rita Carter at County Hall.